Have you ever been the only different person in the room? Do you know what it feels like to stand out? Not because of what you bring, but simply because you don't look like everyone else. Imagine being the only woman in the room, the only woman on the panel, the only woman whose voice is barely heard or politely ignored. I don't have to imagine it. I have lived it. I'm a woman in technology, a part of the minority. And if you are too, or have worked in a male-dominated field, you probably know exactly what I mean. And yet, somehow, this is treated as normal. Let me be clear. This is not normal, and this should not be acceptable. We have been in the meetings, we've sat through conferences, we've listened to the same promises about the need for more women in leadership and also strengthening diversity. All the right things are being said on stages, in reports, and in carefully worded pledges. Words are not enough. As a woman who's lived this experience, I wanted more than a pledge. I decided to become intentional and make progress. I co-founded the Ubuntu AI community, which is a grassroots initiative with the goal of advancing AI in Zambia and demystifying it for a broader community. Our community is rooted on inclusivity. I have also organized women in tech workshops and conferences, bringing together hundreds of women in a space where we do not feel like the only one. And yet, the data tells a different story. In a report on the state of AI in Zambia, which I proudly contributed to in 2024, our research revealed something both familiar and sobering. Only 20% of women are making it in AI-related leadership roles in Zambia. Men, 79%. This disparity is alarming. Meanwhile, progress toward the UN Sustainable Development Goal, gender equality by 2030, is slipping further out of reach according to an SDG report of 2023. This led me to ask myself a very difficult question. Are we truly making progress towards gender equality, or have we reached a plateau that looks like that is disguised as progress? As we enter a new age, the age of artificial intelligence, this technology brings with it a fork in the road. It can be a powerful force for gender equality or a silent architect for deeper inequality. We stand at a pivotal moment. AI is no longer on the horizon. It's here. But AI is more than just ChatGPT. AI powers what we see on TikTok. It influences the jobs we get offered and the nature of healthcare we get access to now. These systems don't look like robots always. They are always working silently, quietly, and often behind the scenes without us even realizing it. And that's why this matters, because the most dangerous biases are not the ones that we see. It's those that are silently shaping our lives. AI is reshaping our lives, how we work, how we connect, and even how we love. It's reshaping our everyday experiences. And this raises an agent question. Will AI help break the gender barriers? Or will it build even bigger barriers? Will it open doors for women? Or will it quietly lock us out? Imagine a world where machines influence who gets the job, whose loan gets approved, And who even goes to jail? Now, imagine those machines have been trained on biased data, which reflects decades of discrimination. That world is not hypothetical. We are currently living in it. We've already seen several warning signs. For example, in 2018, a Reuters report revealed that Amazon's AI recruiting tool was giving preference to men over women. Any resume with the word women in it would be penalized. Amazon had to scrap off that recruiting tool. In 2019, MIT Review did report that Apple's AI credit card algorithm was giving women lower credit limits compared to men, even when the women had better financial profiles. It was the women of these husbands of these women who had to call out the bias publicly. When the Apple algorithm could not be explained, it just showed how bias can hide behind the code. But why does this happen? It happens because AI learns from the past. And when we look at the past, it hasn't been fair. Because the teams that are building these systems often lack diversity to question the outputs. Add on to the fact that women only make up to 30% of the global AI workforce, according to a UNESCO report of 2025. If we want fairer AI, AI that saves all of humanity, we need more than better code. We need diverse teams developing, testing, and regulating these systems. We need representative data, data that reflects a full spectrum of the human experience and not only segments of it. We need more transparency and oversight because AI has to be understood at the bare minimum by the people it's impacting. These systems shouldn't be black boxes. Women. We need to be more than consumers of AI. We need to be part of the developers, part of the decision makers, part of the regulators and testers. You don't necessarily have to be in technology to shape the future of AI. AI needs humanity. It needs ethicists. It needs advocates. It needs educators. It needs all of us. The future that we want will not be coded by accident. It will be coded by all of us. Ahead of the International Women's Day 2025, UNESCO released a report exposing persistent gender stereotypes in large language models. Women were 4 times more likely to be associated with domestic roles compared to men. Words like home, family, and children often dominated women's profiles. Men, on the other hand, had words like career, executive, and salary dominating their profiles. That's not the future that we want. But it's the future that we seem headed towards unless we act. So how do we act? Women, whether you're in tech or not, AI is shaping our future. It's influencing the kind of healthcare we access, the finances that we access, the credit limits that we have, and even the jobs we get offered. We don't necessarily need to learn how to code to care. All we need to be is engaged, be curious, ask the right questions, because one day it won't be a human being that will be determining your next course of action. It will be an autonomous machine. To the leaders in the room, ensure your teams are diverse. Invest in training, in mentorship, and equity for women. An important question that you also need to ask yourself as a leader is, do the tools in my organization discriminate? If you're not shaking, who is? To the men in the room, be allies. In the Apple credit card example that I gave earlier, it was the husbands of these women who noticed the bias. They spoke up and called it out. They did not remain silent. But you don't necessarily have to wait for it to affect your daughter, your mother, or even your wife to care. Speak up before the bias gets personal. To the men again, don't just give women a seat at the table. Help redesign the table so that it was never exclusive to begin with. My hope is that the next generation of women will not know what it feels like to be the only woman in the room. That equal leadership across gender, race, and background will be the norm and not the exception. But to get there, we need to act. I will leave you with this question. Do you think AI will help break the gender barriers, or will it build even bigger gender barriers? The answer to that question depends on what we do now.